Jackson, the Flying Commando.
Top high above a large city stands the headquarters of a man devoted to the cause of freedom and justice. A war hero who has never stopped fighting against his country's enemies. A private citizen who is dedicating his life to the struggle against evil men everywhere. Get Jackson.
Hello, Tut.
Well,
boy, am I looking forward to a rest. Three hectic missions in a row.
I got the feather beds all turned down so you can crawl right in and relax.
Well, we're not only tired, we're hungry. What do you got that's good?
I'm sorry, sir. The menu hasn't come back from the printer yet, sir. But I'll check with the chef and let you know immediately, sir. Or to put it simply, I'll see what we've got in the refrigerator for you two hungry characters, sir.
Now what?
It's Jerry, our gardener.
I wonder what he wants. Go let him in, will you?
Hi, Jerry. Come on in.
Welcome home, Jeff Jackson.
Thank you, Jerry. Say, that lawn out front is looking mighty good.
You know what they say about gardening, sir? 99% perspiration and 1% fertilizer.
Well, that sounds like about the right mixture. How's night school, Jerry?
Fine, sir. I'm taking my college entrance exams this summer.
Good. I'm glad to hear it. Now, what can I do for you?
I'd like to speak to Mr. Jones, sir, if he's not busy.
Sure. Tut. Oh, Jerry.
Mr. Jones, I just wanted to ask you again. Did you find it?
Oh, yes. Yes, found it out in the grass near the runway. There you are.
Thank you so much. If I'd lost it, I thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, say, Jerry, you mind if I take a look at that?
Why, yes, sir.
I've seen just one of those before. It was a long way from here. It's the Kinchikuncho medal, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Kinchi what?
Kinchikuncho. It's Japan's highest award for valor. It's like our Congressional Medal of Honor.
Wow.
That's as high as they come.
Was it won by someone you know?
Yes, sir. My father, in World War II.
He must have been a very brave man.
Yes, sir, he was a brave man. He got this early in the war. He gave it to my mother to keep for him.
Was he?
No, sir. He's still alive.
Oh, in a hospital?
No, sir. He never came back from the war.
Never came back?
Missing in action, huh?
No, sir. He just never came back.
You mean he's in hiding somewhere?
Yes, sir. On Kangaluk. One of the Pacific Islands. He never surrendered.
Never surrendered?
But you must understand, sir. There were three of them. Before the war, they were peasants. They did only what they were ordered to do by their leaders.
Well, they still won't believe the war is over. Is that it?
Oh, sure, I remember. There were a lot of Japanese soldiers like that. I thought they all come in by now.
They are the last ones. They've been forgotten by everyone except their families.
Both the Japanese and American governments tried to bring them in years ago. They did everything they could. They sent radio messages, they dropped leaflets. But those soldiers just wouldn't give up. They thought it was some sort of a trick.
Do you remember your father, Jerry?
Just barely. I was very small. He was so kind to me. No, he must be almost insane.
Maybe not. He might listen to you. Would you like to try?
How could I?
Ikky and I could take you there in the Silver Dart.
Oh, Jeff Jackson, that would be wonderful, but...
Your butt is right. I thought you wanted to rest.
Ikky, this boy has a right to see his father. How's he ever going to see him again unless we take him there?
Yeah, but gosh,
I'll fire up the Silver Dart.
Island again?
Kangaluk, in the South Pacific.
South Pacific? Oh, boy. Palm trees, coconuts, hula girls.
Ikky, Ikky.
I want to scratch my back on the little grand shack on the old Pacific shore.
Ikky.
I want to go back there once more. Hey, you like the guy who got the guy you. Yeah?
Congo, look, isn't that kind of an island?
It isn't.
No. It's more on the order of the Borneo or Sumatra jungles, and lots of animal life.
Animal life? Oof.
Don't worry, Ikky, from what I hear, if you don't bother them, they won't bother you. That's the law of the jungle.
Just so. Well, I never bothered a wild animal in my life, and I'm sure not going to start now.
Well, there are also tribes of savage natives on Congo, look.
Well, I won't bother them either.
But they might bother us. See, about 100 years ago, renegade white men kidnapped the natives by the hundreds, took them back to Australia and forced them to work on cotton and sugar plantations. As a result, the natives hid in the jungle, lived like savages, and to this day consider all white men their enemies.
Hey, that's Congo look down there, huh?
Well, let's pick out a hard switch beach and take her in for a landing. Of course, we respect your opinion, mein Herr von Ranck, as a man who has lived in this country for many years, but...
28 years I lived on this island. This little trading boat, perhaps it's not very much, but it's the last outpost of civilization on Congo Look. Out there is jungle, infested by wild animals, snakes and insects. Something worse.
What do you mean?
Savages.
Savages? This is the 20th century.
Out there is no 20th century. Out there it is prehistory.
Well, that may be so, but there are civilized men out there, three Japanese.
If they're still alive.
My father is still alive. I just know it.
And we'll find him, Jerry, and the others.
If you two want to risk your lives, you are a grown-up man. But he is a lad. To let him go is criminal.
But I want to go.
I know you do, Jerry. But Mr. von Ranck is right. We can't let you. Can he stay here with you?
Of course.
It's going to be pretty hard trying to persuade his father to...
That's why you need me, so I can talk to him.
But we can't risk your life, Jerry. Now, we'll get him out, Ikky and I, somehow. Then you can talk to him. Can you get me a native guide and a bearer?
I guess them. How long they're going to stay with you, I cannot guarantee. Timber! Timber! Akavuk awala. Akavuk alawak awa. Timber!
This reminds you when I was a Boy Scout. Hiking, hiking, and more hiking.
That's good for us, Ikky. We spend too much time on that airplane as it is.
Yeah, well, it's still my favorite way of getting around. Hey, what's that?
Oh, it's just some kind of a howling monkey.
Oh. Well, I'd howl too if I had to live in this steaming jungle all my life.
Go, Tamba.
If we ever get out of this jungle, I'm never going to walk again.
Mm. Oh, walking's not so bad. When you have to start running, the things really get interesting.
Yeah. Oh, am I sleepy? I'm going to hit the sack. Run! You mean you think we'll be chased out of this jungle?
Well, like I said, we've got to be prepared for anything. Tiger.
What am I worried about? It won't bother him. He won't bother me. That's the law of the jungle. Hey. Can't we stop and rest? I'm half asleep.
You should have slept last night.
I tried. I couldn't. I kept seeing natives throw long spears. I was having nightmares.
Fire over their heads. It may scare them away.
That ought to hold them for a while.
Why don't we just shoot them and be done with it?
No, there'd just be hundreds more to take their place. I'd rather deal with these few. Besides, I want them to know that we mean them no harm.
You know, they could surround us in this thick jungle. We wouldn't know it.
Yeah. We've got to find a clearing, Ikky.
Hey, what happened to our bears?
Oh, I imagine they circled around, found a trail back home.
Let's follow them.
We don't know these jungles, Ikky. We might as well continue in the direction our bearers were headed. Come on.
Well, you think we're safe? You think they had enough?
There's your answer.
Better sit down and take it easy, my boy. In this heat.
I can't take it easy. I'm too worried.
About your friend?
Yes, and about my father.
Umaguma Kawawa.
Guma Sawawa?
Why? What's happened? They're not coming back, are they?
Shoot him. Give them both barrels. Let's have them. I'll give it to them. Oh, I'm sorry, sir. Is everything all right?
Everything's all right on my watch. Have you got enough sleep so I can get some sleep now?
Oh, yeah, sure thing.
If you hear anything suspicious, wake me up.
Oh, I will. Still no sign of those guys we're after. When are we going to give up?
I don't like to give up, Ikky, on anything.
Well, sure, I know, but our supplies are almost gone.
Hey, look. Hello there. We are your friends. Hey, wait a minute. Listen. You've got to listen. Wait. And we fell into it. Hey, listen. We are Americans, your friends.
There's no more fighting, no more war. It's all over.
Hey, look! Guns! No shoot! Hey! Come back here! We're your friends! You can't leave us this way!
Ah, it's no use, Ikky. Hey, I got an idea. Give me that rifle. Get on my shoulders.
Can you reach it?
We're about 4 feet too short.
Come down.
They want to kill us. Why?
Well, that's the safest way for them, Ikky. We're armed and they're not. They probably used up the last of their ammunition years ago.
Japanese soldiers think they can come back after we're dead and get our ammunition, huh?
Yeah, that's what they're counting on.
Yeah. Well, they're not going to get it. Warn them.
That branch up there?
Yeah.
Now, if that fell in here, we could wedge it between the sides and pull ourselves out.
You hit it!
I've got to keep on hitting it in the same place.
Japanese friends must think we're running out of ammunition real fast, huh?
We are.
Hey, that branch is taking a lot of a punishment, but it just won't break.
3 bullets left.
Is that all?
That's all.
It's cracking. Last bullet.
I'll hoist you up. You throw one end over the branch and pull yourself out. Down.
Okay. Vine's coming right up. I mean, right down. Jerry, how did you get here?
I bribed a native to guide me. He ran away, and I lost the track. Then I heard some shooting.
Hey, Jerry's here. He's fainted.
I'll tie it off. How is he?
He's fine now.
Someone's coming. Quick, hide him in the brush.
Father. Father. You must listen to me. It is I, your son. Remember this medal? You gave it to my mother.
My son.
Let's give him a moment to talk.
Yeah, I guess they got a lot to talk about.
Can't tell what they're saying, but they look mighty happy.
My father, he's all right now. He knows I told the truth that the war is over and they must come back. He's sorry for what he tried to do, but he'll take us back by another way, avoiding the tribal sages.
Say, that's the best news I heard since the war ended.
My father says he thanks you from his heart. Risking your lives for former enemies is the most generous thing he has ever heard of. He hopes that our two countries will remain friends for all time.
Well, tell him that we and our country also wish to remain friends for all time with everyone. Mission takes us to an island in the South Seas and $500,000 in stolen money. Now, this is no ordinary flight, but a race against time and a band of desperate criminals. It is also a battle against the terrors of the jungle and a devastating typhoon that roars out of the sea. We'll rendezvous here as usual. Until then, this is Jet Jackson, signing off with the code of the Secret Squadron. Justice through strength and courage. Out.
The Flying Commando!